remember your final day of school? Well, at the time, you may have been pretty excited about walking out those gates one last time, but as the years go by, maybe you realise it was actually one of the best times of your life. Our very own Sarah Harris took a step back in time visiting some very special individuals who helped shape her.
We all remember Robin Williams' character in Dead Poets Society.
Seize the day. Gather ye rosebuds while ye may. Why does the writer use these lines?
Because he's in a hurry.
No.
Ding.
Thank you for playing anyway. Because we are food for worms, lads.
A great teacher is someone who gives you an education that stays with you long after you've forgotten what you've learned at school.
Gosh, I cannot believe it's been nearly 20 years since I farewelled my old school, Caboolture State High, and I walked out of these very gates into the big wide world. I can still remember being 17 and being really excited to leave behind the books and the exams and school to start my life, real life. But even after all of these years, there are two very special people that I haven't forgotten.
About an hour's drive north of Brisbane, Caboolture High is a huge yet pretty humble public school that's been educating kids for 127 years. It's even produced a couple of famous graduates.
Going well, Sarah.
No, I don't mean me. I'm talking proper famous. Like legendary golfer Ian Baker Finch.
Oh, that's a bonus. When you push your arms
around me. And country music superstar Keith Urban. When I started Year 8 back in 1994, East 17 were in the charts, the internet was just firing up, and Friends was must-watch TV.
I just want $1 million!
Which meant the Rachel was all the rage. Here's a 14-year-old me attempting to rock it. How embarrassment. Back then, I was an awkward kid with bad skin who had just changed schools after struggling to fit in.
Oh my God!
One teacher who brought me out of my shell was this brilliant man.
And you still had the bum bag!
I did it just for you.
How are you?
I'm so good, Sarah.
Oh my God, it's so nice to see you. This is Mr. Boxall, my English teacher through high school, who was just so beautiful to me. Honestly, you just put me onto an incredible path and you were so nurturing to me and lovely and beautiful, and I feel like I owe you a huge thanks. A huge, huge thanks.
Oh, well, I think any time you have a student that is as wonderful as you've been. I mean, I think that we wouldn't have been any teacher that would have said anything other than wonderful words about you.
Oh, so, I don't know about that. I don't know about that. Check's in the mail.
Yeah.
I often wondered, you know, if I ever put a story to air, would Mr. Boxall be watching? Would that be grammatically correct to say this? It's kind of weird, isn't it?
It is a little, yeah.
That's sort of the way things have ended up.
Yeah.
But, gee, it's nice to be back.
It is.
I feel like I'm 17 again.
Good grief.
Yeah.
Don't do that to anybody. Yeah.
So weird being back here, seeing the school hall where I snuck my very first kiss. Even the spot where I used to eat lunch has hardly changed.
It's exactly the same.
Yeah, right down to the metal benches, I imagine, yeah.
Do you remember all that the cool kids would sit around here? They were called the tuck shop girls.
They were the cool kids.
They were the cool kids. They were like the pink ladies of Caboolture.
Who said, I don't think the cool kids sit around the tuck shop anymore.
And here's my old homeroom, where I started my day every day for 5 years, with this wonderful woman.
Do you recognise me?
You I have
certainly
not
recognise
you.
A bit. Nonsense. I'm nearly 20 years older.
Oh my God, you're
but you
fabulous!
Because I've actually been watching you on TV.
Oh, Mrs. Woodhouse, gosh, I can still remember the first day walking into this room.
I can remember your first day.
I can remember your
first day at school.
Oh.
I can remember the fact that you'd been at a different school for the first 4 days of the year and you'd gone home in tears.
I was.
And come to us instead. And we were so pleased.
Oh, it was, you know, it was
It was the start of, I think, just my new life, I think.
And their loss was our gain.
So Mrs. Woodhouse was my homeroom teacher.
That's so.
So for 5 years, I
we
checked in
each
here.
Other every day.
Every single day. And then she was my debating teacher.
And your English teacher at times.
That's right, that's right. I remember thinking growing up, you were almost a bit like the Queen.
Oh,
so
God.
Dignified. and
I just had one of my former staff members saying to me, oh, Cecilia, you almost made me think of Queen Elizabeth.
It's true. It's true. Just so well spoken and articulate, and I remember.
I thought it could have been worse. She could have said Queen Victoria.
No.
You used to work hard at everything.
Yeah.
And you probably still do work hard at everything.
I was a bit of a stressed kid, wasn't
I? You were.
I?
You were.
Why was I so stressed out?
Because she wanted to be perfect.
Yeah.
It's not a bad thing.
No, but I've kind
but
of
yes,
realised that it's okay
stressful.
Not to be. Yeah.
Are you like that still?
I'm working on it.
They might insist that I call them Ian and Cecilia now, but they'll always be Mr. Boxall and Mrs. Woodhouse to me, two very special teachers whose lessons extended beyond books and blackboards.
You talk about having special kids, but I think a lot of that comes down to having super special teachers. And despite it being almost 20 years later, I often think about you both. It almost makes me a little bit emotional thinking about which way my life might have headed if I hadn't had such wonderful role models.
Maybe motherhood has changed me, or maybe it's just part of growing up. But now I have a whole new appreciation for my teachers and all the nurturing that they did in my teenage years.
It was a poem, and it was all about stopping to smell the roses.
Yes, I did.
Was that you?
Yes.
Yes, I knew it was you. I think it might have been a mark that didn't come back my way. And, you know, not just being a teacher, you were also just a really good human in life as well. And I remember you said, I want to see you after class. And you said, oh, look, I want you to read this. Take it away and read it. And I just think you should underline. I think you might have even highlighted the bit, you know, it's important
that
to take
right.
It was a poem. It was a poem.
To stop and smell the roses.
Yes.
And I kept that
and
for
you.
It was a poem. And I would highlight. I highlight everything. So, yeah, definitely me.
Coming back here feels like the big warm hug I should have given them years ago.
But can I just say, you have left me, both of you, forever changed, and I am so grateful to have had you both as my teachers.
That's
thanks,
lovely.
Sarah.
High school.
If you wanted the moon, I would try to make it
stop. What a beautiful, beautiful story, and yet again just reinforcing, as Sarah so said so well, in regards to the difference that teachers make, and they get a really, really tough time sometimes.
Yeah.
They can change a person's life.
And you had good teachers?
Yeah. I had wonderful teachers, and I loved school, and they did. I was incredibly homesick when I went to boarding school, and I was so incredibly homesick I cried myself to sleep for about a year. And Mrs. Moore, who has sadly now passed away, if it wasn't for her, I wouldn't have been able to stick it out.
Aww.
Every day she would just, you know, those words of encouragement. Yeah.
But you cried yourself to sleep for a year. Oh, Tash.
Right. Mrs. Moore certainly took her time, didn't she?
No, but I was
you
really
do
homesick.
Remember the names. I think there's always a teacher that will stick with you in terms of how they either believe in you when no one else does, and often during your teenage years
who
that can be a very
then?
Challenging time. School was sort of, I tell you what, Moore University.
Yes.
I had an amazing lecturer called Leonora Ritter, who was fantastic.
Mm.
And so for me, university was where I blossomed.
Yeah. Doesn't it just show you that just the importance of education?
Oh, indeed.
How it can just transform your life, send you on a path.
Yep.
And that's why Sarah Harris has always been so passionate. It's why she helps out the Smith family, which helps kids who can't afford to get all the educational stuff that they need. So that it's so important.
My youngest daughter, Sienna, she's in year 12 at school at the moment. So she's just come out of year 11, going into year 12. And, you know, really got high hopes on good marks. But you come back and it comes down to the teachers every time, you know.
Yes.
And just you talk to her after, you know, her English. She loves the English teacher and you know that she's going to excel in those topics that, you know, the teachers have a great relationship with them. So, no, I'm really confident she's got good, you know, good teachers there at school.
She
and she's feeling really good about herself.